गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई विल कंप्लीट द चैप्टर दैट इज एन एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी फीट दैट इज टेकन फ्रॉम द बुक इंग्लिश इम्पल्स रिलेटेड टू स्टैंडर्ड 7. सो इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैड ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन द प्रीवियस पैराग्राफ ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. Now in this video I will complete the chapter. But before we start, I have to summarize the chapter. Well, this chapter, the main protagonist of this chapter name is J.C. Owen. Well, the J.C. Owen wanted to participate in the athlete event, but he was unable, because as in this chapter we come to know that on 25th May 1935 he got his pain in his back and he was thinking whether he would be able to participate in the event or not. But so he decided to consult his university coach Larry Snyder, where they come to know that after each event they will decide whether J.C. Owens will participate or not. Finally, J.C. Owens had participated some types of event, that is 100 yard dash, long jump, 220 yard race, 220 yard hurdles, and he got qualified and broke the all the previous record that had done by someone. And one of the sport experts said that it was the single greatest and finest athletic performance that they have ever seen. James Cleveland, actual name was James Cleveland Owens. He was born in 1913 in the southern part of United States. At the age of 9, his family moved to city of Ohio, and when he went to the school, an anonymous teacher asked his name, and when he replied J.C. Owen, the teacher misheard him and his name was noted in the school as J.C. Owen. As you can see in the video that I have already shown it to you, J.C. Owen, but its actual name is James Cleveland Owens. J.C. Owen was dedicated for athletics. He took interested in the track and field race. So his school coach Charles Riley always motivated him to participate. That's why J.C. Owen gained his popularity and achieved all his goal he had achieved. And finally, on 3rd of August 1936, J.C. won his first gold medal for the 100 meters event. On next day, 4th August 1936, there was an event called long jump. Owens was disqualified. Why he was disqualified? Because he had crossed the take-off line in first two attempts. Now, J.C. Owens had only one chance, and J.C. Owens had also his competitor. And his competitor name was Luge Long. His competitor Luge Long had decided to give him some advice, and J.C. Owen accepted his advice, and finally he got succeed. J.C. Owens beat Luge Long in the finals and won the gold medal. That was the most unforgettable moment for J.C. Owens. He was achieve. And his competitor Lord Lung was the first to congratulate him. Now, coming to the next paragraph, second last paragraph, that is J.C. Owens. J.C. Owens, an underprivileged young man who could have never dreamed of this kind of fame, had taken the athletic world by storm in the space of just 4 years. J.C. Owens was an underprivileged young man. Underprivileged means the man who was deprived, who was the lacking of his right. That's why, because his family financial condition was not good. That's why, and he never thought that he gained popularity, this type of popularity. He had achieved all the goals, all the event that he had participated. But unfortunately, this great athlete would never be seen again in amateur competition. Unfortunately means by bad luck, this great athlete, J.C. Owens, would have never seen again in amateur competition. Why? We will come to know in next few lines. The financial situation of his family meant that he wanted to take advantage of his newfound fame to earn money as a professional athlete. His family financial condition was not good. If he wanted, he could earn money as a professional athlete who would be paid for participating in event. But working as a professional athlete, he could no longer compete in international events like the Olympic. That's why he denied. So that in next last paragraph, towards the later years, Owens was appointed a goodwill ambassador for the United States, traveling the world as a representative of the country. Owens later traveled to Germany again for the 1972 Munich Olympic. Owens died in 1980, leaving an almost unparalleled benchmark for later athletes. This paragraph describes us that J.C. Owens was also appointed as a goodwill ambassador who represented the United States, who represented the world of its country. J.C. Owens also traveled to Germany as he wanted to attend 1972 Munich Olympics. At last, J.C. Owens died in 1980 and left us an almost unparalleled benchmark for later athletes, which means no one can compare, that nobody compete J.C. Owens in the field of athletics. That's why he was well known of the athletics. He was well known athletic person, and he was also born in 1930. So basically this story describes us about a person named J.C. Owens, who was suffering from his back pain. Even he had participated all these events and got succeed and broke all the record. That's why this chapter title name is An Extraordinary Feat. That means achievement or goal that is not common. So in this chapter we have come to know that no matter what, if we are determined that what we have to do or what we want to do, we will do. All we have acquired, all we have to, that is dedication, competence, capability. If you have determined, you will do all the thing that you want. So this chapter ends, and hope you have understood this chapter. I wish, and now in my next class we will do question answer. Thank you. Have a good day.